Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048, that's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
Danny Merritt here, co-founder of Nine Line Apparel, proudly running for United States Congress in Georgia's 1st District. I know what it takes to create jobs here in Georgia's 1st District. Through Nine Line Apparel, we've created hundreds and hundreds of jobs. I know what it takes to serve my country. I've served proudly in the United States Army for 18 years. I'm asking to go to Washington, D.C. and represent you all here in Georgia's 1st and make you proud. I'm asking for your vote. Vote Merritt for Congress on June 9th.
I'm Danny Merritt, running for United States Congress, District 1, and I approve this message.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020 at Wayne County High School. The following businesses, individuals, and organizations wish you good luck and good fortune in the years to come. Calvary Baptist Church would like to congratulate Ray Landrup, Adriana Martin, Blake McElwain, Ian Nichols, J.C. O'Quinn, Donald Portfilio, Kai Riddle, and Graham Welch. Jones Prescription Shop would like to congratulate 2020 graduating seniors Chrissy O'Banion and Will Scarborough. We are all very proud of you. Keith Electronics would like to congratulate Kelly Appler and Kyler Keith and all 2020 graduating seniors. Calvary Baptist Church would like to congratulate Lane Wasden, Spencer Wasden, Logan Clark at Coastal Plains, and Will Scarborough Homeschool.
The helpful folks at Harris Ace Hardware say thank you for choosing Harris Ace as your favorite place to buy hardware and building supplies. Stop by Harris Ace Hardware and check out their weekly deals. Sign up for Ace Rewards and start earning points toward coupons and rewards. You'll even receive a $5 coupon just for signing up. Harris Ace Hardware in Jessup, Hinesville, Ulonia, and now in Brunswick. They are ready to serve your everyday building and hardware needs. Harris Ace Hardware.
In the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic, it is important not to put your health care on hold. Preventative testing, lab work, elective diagnostic, and surgical procedures are available at Wayne Memorial Hospital and are vital to ensure your continued good health. At Wayne Memorial, we prioritize your health and safety. You can be confident that all appropriate safety measures remain in place to protect our patients. At Wayne Memorial, you will find clean, open areas in which social distancing is enforced. Surfaces are regularly sanitized by our skilled environmental services staff, and HEPA certified air filters are located throughout the hospital, ensuring the cleanest air possible. Our staff has ample supply of protective personal equipment, and face masks and hand sanitizers are readily available to our patients. We look forward to the day when we are able to lift our no visitors policy. Regardless of the COVID-19 virus, our friends, family, and neighbors are still suffering from heart disease, cancer, neurological problems, and much more. Please don't delay your important health care needs any longer. Schedule your services at Wayne Memorial Hospital today, where your health means everything to us.
My customers comes first at First Franklin Financial. It's not just a slogan, it's the way we do business. Since 1941, we've been helping our friends and neighbors in the Southeast with their financial needs. We offer personal loans, bill consolidation loans, and more. So stop by our office today. We're conveniently located at 1074 North Macon Street, or give us a call at 912-427-4237. You can also start your application online at www.1ffc.com. All loan terms and applicable APR depends on meeting our underwriting and income criteria for the loan size requested. It may require collateral. Georgia Residential Mortgage Licensee, number 5656.
When further treatment is no longer an option, hospice can provide services to manage symptoms and difficulties caused by illness, emotional, psychosocial, and spiritual care, as well as support to the families and caregivers are all part of hospice care. Hospice of South Georgia has been a part of the health community in Wayne and surrounding counties since 1998. The professional yet compassionate attention provided by our staff is unsurpassed. Widely supported by donations from the local population, Hospice of South Georgia is the local nonprofit hospice in Wayne County. Our administrative office is located at 1625 Sunset Boulevard, and Hospice of South Georgia accepts anyone who meets hospice criteria regardless of their ability to pay. Please call 912-588-0080 to speak with someone about hospice care. That was 912-588-0080. We are your hometown hospice, and we are here to serve you. Hospice of South Georgia, working to add life to your days.
Local news on WIFO.
It's time now for Local History and Local News. In the news today and Friday, we'll wind up 3 weeks of early voting as the Georgia primary and local elections set to take place on Tuesday, June the 9th, with polls opening Tuesday at 7 a.m. and closing at 7 p.m. And the results will be revealed. WIFOFM will be your election headquarters that evening. On Wednesday, the registrar's office reports that 108 people voted, 99 Republicans and 9 Democrats. That brings the grand total of voters thus far in Wayne County 1,198 that have showed up to the registrar's office to vote. There are 16,000 registered voters in the county. Over 2,000 absentee ballots have been received at the local office. Probate Judge Tammy Thornton reports that her staff will begin opening those ballots this coming Monday. On Monday's Butch and Bob show, she'll join us along with Chief Registrar Susan Nash as they'll be our guest to update the number of votes cast during the 3 week early voting period and also discuss what voters can expect when they head to the polls this coming Tuesday. And the big interest locally is the race for sheriff, as one of four men on the Republican ballot will be elected sheriff. Incumbent John Carter seeking another term, but his opposition from Chuck Mosley, Paul Draudy, and Toby Cameron. Most believe the top two will head to a runoff, but if one candidate receives 50% plus one, they can avoid a runoff. Once again, everyone will know the results this coming Tuesday. A reminder, registrar's office again open today from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and tomorrow from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. If you have any questions about early voting, simply call the registrar's office at 427-5950. Be a busy day in Brunswick today as the Glenn County Courthouse is the site for a preliminary hearing at 9:30 a.m. for the three men charged in the Aubemont Arbery case, three men charged with murder and the shooting death. They'll appear via video in the courtroom as they will remain in jail. All three suspects are represented by different attorneys. Cobb County DA Joy Holmes, now the prosecutor in the case, she'll be on hand. Again, this hearing in front of the magistrate judge in Glenn County is a preliminary hearing, but much expected to be revealed as far as some of the facts in the case. WIFOFM will be on hand, have a full report for you on Friday's newscast. And after the hearing, a rally on behalf of Aubemont Arbery expected to be held in Brunswick today as well, and heavy police force on hand. Once again, their preliminary hearing is set for this morning at 9:30 a.m. Again, we'll have a full report for you tomorrow here on the local news. We'll come back with more news after this word from our sponsor, the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
When further treatment is no longer an option, hospice can provide services to manage symptoms and difficulties caused by illness, emotional, psychosocial, and spiritual care, as well as support to the families and caregivers are all part of hospice care. Hospice of South Georgia has been a part of the health community in Wayne and surrounding counties since 1998. The professional yet compassionate attention provided by our staff is unsurpassed. Widely supported by donations from the local population, Hospice of South Georgia is the local nonprofit hospice in Wayne County. Our administrative office is located at 1625 Sunset Boulevard, and Hospice of South Georgia accepts anyone who meets hospice criteria regardless of their ability to pay. Please call 912-588-0080 to speak with someone about hospice care. That was 912-588-0080. We are your hometown hospice, and we are here to serve you. Hospice of South Georgia. Working to add life to your days.
Hello, this is Paul Draudy, candidate for sheriff of Wayne County. Fight harder against drugs, combat domestic violence, address quality of life crimes, institute police zones, ensure a responsible budget, and hold people accountable. These are my six platform issues that I announced on July 1, 2019. They haven't changed. It's been my plan from the beginning. PaulDraudyForSheriff.com. This ad paid for by Paul Draudy for Sheriff.
Other news, the summer feeding program got underway this week, and it runs today. Again, it's every Tuesday and Thursday from June 2nd to July 30th. These are the locations: Wayne County High School, Martha Rawl Smith Elementary, Jessup and Odom Elementary, World Class Karate and Scriven Community Center. The time, each Tuesday and Thursday from 10:30 to 11:30 a.m. Meals will be provided for multiple days. Pickup will be drive-through only. No on-site eating. Again, it's available for children 0 to 18 and people with special needs. Breakfast and lunch will be provided in each bag. Once again, the summer feeding program begins today and runs up through July 30th each Tuesday and Thursday morning. If you have a child or know someone with a child who will be 4 years of age before September 1st of 2020, the pre-kindergarten online registration for the year 2020-2021 school year may be found on the Wayne County website at www.wayne.k12.ga.us under the heading 2020-2021 pre-kindergarten online registration link. And the pre-kindergarten registration deadline is Friday, June 19th. Application receipts for children after this date will be placed on a waiting list. It's now official. Georgia lawmakers will return to Atlanta to complete the legislative session. The date now, June 15th, again set in stone. Legislators' main task will be passing the budget, which will be vastly different than the one they approved before the coronavirus pandemic slowed Georgia's economy nearly to a halt. For more than a month, Lieutenant Governor and House Speaker debated on what date the session would reconvene. They have 11 days left on the 40-day session. Ross and the House Speaker wanted June the 11th, the Lieutenant Governor June 15th. General Assembly suspended the session in mid-March in an effort to slow the spread of the COVID-19. Governor Brian Kemp told state agencies on Wednesday that he's projecting an 11% drop in state tax collections in the upcoming fiscal year due to the virus recession. That will likely be some good news, as the earlier projections were much worse. Kemp's projection means lawmakers will have about $2.6 billion less to spend in fiscal year 2021, which begins July 1st, and they have less than a month to pass a state budget. But once again, the date has been set. Again, it is official. They'll reconvene on June 15th. In a press conference this week, Georgia Governor Brian Kemp says he will do whatever is necessary to keep peace and prevent protests demanding racial justice from turning into violent demonstrations. He committed to holding a dialogue with organizers when the situation calms. Governor, who deployed thousands of National Guard troops to reinforce local and state officers, says authorities will be on high alert today in Brunswick during this court hearing in the slaying of death of Ahmaud Arbery. Governor says officials will crack down on bad actors if they infiltrate peaceful gatherings after a march against police violence in Atlanta over the weekend developed into looting and chaos that damaged parts of downtown Buckhead. Governor upset about an Atlanta police officer struck last Saturday by an ATV while patrolling what became a chaotic protest near Centennial Olympic Park. Governor says you have a perfectly innocent police officer get hit on a four-wheeler. He says it's a miracle that he's still alive, but he's alive because the National Guard was there. Officer remains hospitalized today at Grady Memorial. State and city officials have pinned the blame on the violence from out-of-state demonstrators. Vic Reynolds of the GBI, when pressed on that issue, offered no specifics. He did state that from the information that his department has received, that there are individuals in Atlanta from various groups around the country. He says their sole intent is to cause destruction and violence. We'll come back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned.
Change is one big thing you can count on. And as life changes, you can count on Altamaha Federal Credit Union to help keep you and your family's finances on solid ground. We'll help you keep more of what you earn and make the most of what you have. Visit us to see how we can guide you and your family towards financial success through all life's changes. Altamaha Federal Credit Union, Jessup, Lutowisi, and Scriven. Visit us at altamaha.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Western Sizzlin' is now back, open 7 days a week. Their popular seafood buffet is back on Friday nights from 4 until 8, and breakfast is back on Saturday mornings from 7 until 11. Plus, Western Sizzlin' is now back open Sundays from 11 until 8. Stop by today and enjoy all your favorites from Western Sizzlin's menu or enjoy their amazing buffet. Don't forget the to-go window Monday through Saturday from 11 until 7. Western Sizzlin' on South 1st Street in Jessup, now back, open 7 days a week.
This is Charles Huffman at Jessup Housing Outlet. If you haven't been to Jessup Housing Outlet lately, you're missing out on a large selection of new and exciting floor plans from the nation's top manufacturers like Clayton, Fleetwood, Scottbilt, and Homes of Merit. All of our homes feature modern kitchens and appliances, our 60 and higher insulation values, thermopane windows, and energy efficient heat pumps. We have two locations to serve you, 2452 Savannah Highway in Jessup and Highway 301 South between I-16 and the bypass in Statesboro. Come see Charles, Faye, or Sherida today.
Final notes of news. Don't forget the Catfish Tournament is set for this weekend, Saturday and Sunday. The tournament gets underway Saturday at 12 noon, continues until Sunday at 12 noon. This year's tournament offers fishermen the opportunity to win $7,500 first-place payout. Other place payouts determined by the number of entries into the event. Weigh-in and tournament headquarters once again at J.C. Landing at the J.C. Fairgrounds. Those fishing in the tournament can put in anywhere in the Altamaha River, but they must be in line at weigh-in at the fairgrounds by this Sunday at 12 noon. tournament officials asking entrants to please note that you must come to the fairgrounds to receive your T-shirt. Because of continuing concerns with COVID-19, weigh-in will be limited to tournament participants only. Entry fee for the event, $100 per fisherman, with a minimum of at least two fishing in a boat. Big fish pot entry is $10 per fisherman. Registration can be done online at active.com, or can be dropped off at the Tourism Board office this week at the depot. Registration pack is also available online or at the Jessup Train Depot. If you need more info, call the Tourism Board office at 427-3233 or check out the event website at wangtourism.com. But again, the event is set for this weekend, June 6th and 7th. Finally, the news, the follow-up from Tuesday's city meeting is a question was asked by City Commissioner Nick Harris, who has the authority to cancel a city meeting. This is back when the coronavirus pandemic first hit. Mayor David Earl Keith opted to cancel a meeting due to the fact that there was not much on the agenda and a concern for social distancing. WIFOFM talked with the mayor on Wednesday. He says if you made a mistake, he apologizes, but he says what he would like to have covered and report is the fact that the city of Jessup has cut over $1 million in budget without raising any taxes. Mayor says that's some of the stories that need to be reported. Covering city and county meetings over the past 30 years, school board meetings have never given much thought on who has the right to cancel a government meeting. Just consider it a blessing when one is canceled because that's less work. But we talked with Superintendent Jay Brinson yesterday. He says he and the chairman make that call. We talked with Chairman of the County Commissioners, Herschel Harris. He says the chairman and two other commissioners can make that call. City Attorney Michael Connor was tied up in court all day yesterday. We were unable to get his legal opinion, but we're hoping to receive that soon and help clarify who has the right to cancel a city of Jessup meeting. Is it the mayor? Is it the chairman and the mayor? Still unclear at this time, but should have the answer sometime this week, as they state is listed in the city charter. That's going to do it for latest in local news. Sports comes your way in a few minutes. Bob Morgan saying have a great day.
You've been listening to local news on WIFO. For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
This is Richard Johnson from Wayne County Emergency Management. Please remember to keep Wayne safe by continuing to observe social distancing and other good health guidelines. Remain at least 6 feet apart at all times. Wash your hands frequently for at least 20 seconds, especially having come in contact with commonly touched surfaces such as doorknobs, light switches, telephones, sinks, faucets, and countertops. Please call for sneeze only into a tissue or elbow. This message is brought to you by Wayne County Commission, the Cities of Jessup, Odom, and Scriven, the Chamber of Commerce, IDA, Emergency Management, Board of Education, Wayne Memorial Hospital, and Rainier Advanced Materials.
South Georgia weather. Here's your WIFO forecast. Hi, good morning. Mostly cloudy, but a 40% chance of locally heavy showers and thunderstorms. South breeze highs mid-80s. Mostly cloudy, 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms this evening, low 70. Then tomorrow, partly sunny, 50% chance of showers and thunderstorms, upper 80s. Saturday, mostly cloudy, 50% chance of showers and thunderstorms, high Saturday in the mid-80s. Georgia meteorologist John Weatherby in the GNN Weather Center.
Does your body need some work? At Morton Collision Center, our comprehensive professional auto repair services will restore your vehicle to its pre-accident condition quickly and affordably. Expert collision repair, undetectable color matching, free estimates, all insurance claims welcome, towing from the wreck with your request. Let the friendly staff at Morton Collision Center help you by dealing with the insurance company directly. Call 385-1048, that's 385-1048. We guarantee all of our work. Morton Collision Center.
This is Charles Huffman at Jessup Housing Outlet. If you haven't been to Jessup Housing Outlet lately, you're missing out on a large selection of new and exciting floor plans from the nation's top manufacturers like Clayton, Fleetwood, Scottbilt, and Homes of Merit. All of our homes feature modern kitchens and appliances, R60 and higher insulation values, thermopane windows, and energy-efficient heat pumps. We have two locations to serve you, 2452 Savannah Highway in Jessup and Highway 301 South between I-16 and the bypass in Statesboro. Come see Charles, Faye, or Sherida today.
In the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic, it is important not to put your health care on hold. Preventative testing, lab work, elective diagnostic, and surgical procedures are available at Wayne Memorial Hospital and are vital to ensure your continued good health. At Wayne Memorial, we prioritize your health and safety. You can be confident that all appropriate safety measures remain in place to protect our patients. At Wayne Memorial, you will find clean, open areas in which social distancing is enforced. Surfaces are regularly sanitized by our skilled environmental services staff, and HEPA-certified air filters are located throughout the hospital, ensuring the cleanest air possible. Our staff has ample supply of protective personal equipment, and face masks and hand sanitizers are readily available to our patients. We look forward to the day when we are able to lift our no-visitors policy. Regardless of the COVID-19 virus, our friends, family, and neighbors are still suffering from heart disease, cancer, neurological problems, and much more. Please don't delay your important health care needs any longer. Schedule your services at Wayne Memorial Hospital today, where your health means everything to us.
Since 1946, Murphy's Builder Supply has been serving the folks of Jessup, Wayne, and surrounding counties with quality products and knowledgeable service. Matter of fact, they feel they sell service first to make sure you get exactly what you need for your home improvement projects. And with each employee at Murphy's being there for 10 years or more, you know you're talking with someone with the experience to help you with building supplies, tools, paint, and all the things you need from a full-service hardware store. The best choice in home improvement is Murphy's Builder Supply, 156 Northeast Broad Street, Jessup. For all your medical needs, Tim's Home Medical on South 1st Street in Jessup has you covered. Oxygen, CPAP equipment, wheelchairs, walkers, hospital beds, plus specialty medical equipment from a local company that cares. Tim's Home Medical can handle Medicare, Medicaid, and private insurance billing, as well as family records for tax purposes. Tim's Home Medical, owned and operated by Tim Sloan, 918 South 1st Street in Jessup. Tim's Home Medical. Call 385-2490, 385-2490.
Stop creditor harassment today. Stop the worry of a pending repossession, garnishment, or foreclosure. Contact the Bankruptcy Group, attorney R. Flake Cabinets, for an experienced assessment of your financial situation. They have locations in Brunswick, Hazelhurst, and now Jessup. They are a debt relief agency. They help people file for bankruptcy relief. Contact legal assistant Tanya Blanton at 912-375-5620. 375-5620 to set up your free consultation. Let the Bankruptcy Group do the worrying for you. Now serving Jessup.
Romans 12:3. For I say unto every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think. Brought to you by the Odom Baptist Church.
WIFOFM, Big Dog Country. It is time to check your birthdays and anniversaries. Brought to you today by Bardron Power Sports. Please wish a happy 10th birthday to Aiden Boatwright today. Aiden Boatwright from Uncle Donnie, Aunt Melissa, Lucy, and Ms. Ann. We love you and hope you have a great day. Happy 10th birthday today to Aiden Boatwright. Aiden Boatwright. Happy birthday, Stephen Ellis. Stephen Ellis celebrating today. Happy birthday, Stephen Ellis from the Burgess family today for Stephen Ellis. Verna Betts, having a birthday, Verna Betts. Happy birthday, Addison Kirkland. Addison Kirkland. Ansley Kirkland as well, Ansley Kirkland. Happy birthday, Barbara Landon, Barbara Landon. Chris Ognilla celebrating. Christy Sertich, and Teresa Westbury. Teresa Westbury. Happy birthday from the Robin Eubank State Farm Gang this morning. Long County calendar on this Thursday morning, 4th day of June. Daniel Poland, happy birthday, Daniel Poland, and happy anniversary to Melissa and George Guyette. Melissa and George Guyette, happy anniversary. Birthday wishes, Daniel Poland, and happy anniversary, Melissa and George Guyette. You can textify right now at 912-427-3711. Birthdays, anniversaries on the Big Dog, brought to you by Bargain Power Sports. Happy birthday to Barbara Landon today from Sandy, Andy, and Tyler. Wishing Barbara Landon happy birthday, Barbara Landon, from Sandy, Andy, and Tyler this morning. I would like to wish a happy 34th anniversary to my wife, Pam Arnett, my better half today. Happy anniversary to my wife, Pam Arnett, my better half today. Happy birthday, Lee Sapp, Sean Ziegler, and Grace Drotty. Lee Sapp, Sean Ziegler, Grace Drotty from Bill and Barbara this morning. That's yesterday. Via text 912-427-3711. You've got time to shoot one in right now. Birthdays, anniversaries on the Big Dog, brought to you by Bargain Power Sports.
Famous birthdays today, singer Boz Scaggs, 76. Comedian Jerry Stiller, born 1927.
They said they want you to play the father of George Costanza on Seinfeld. I said, I pass.
Actor Mark Feuerstein is 49.
We are live on the set of Royal Pains with Mark Feuerstein. How are you?
I'm wonderful. I'm so happy to be here in Long Island shooting our fantastic TV show that I love making.
I saw an article about Jerry Stiller that he was supposed to be on The Sopranos, but he was doing a lot of commercial work back about 20 years ago, late 90s, around 2000. He was going to be Hesh on The Sopranos. Jerry Stiller was actually, that just came out recently, he was going to be Hesh as opposed to Jerry Adler on The Sopranos. Happy, happy birthday to Sean Ziegler. Sean Ziegler, we love you so very much and hope you have a great day from Lucy, Bobby, Sandra, Michael, Blake, Levi, and Faith Olivia. Sean Ziegler, happy birthday, Sean Ziegler, today. We're back with your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on WIFO. We'll do that right after this for Bartram Power Sports.
Bartram Power Sports invites everyone to come visit their unbelievable new showroom on Highway 301 South in Jessup and on Highway 341 in Brunswick. They have a great selection of ATVs, golf carts, mowers, and more. Bartram Power Sports carries Arctic Cat four-wheelers and side-by-sides, the new popular Can-Am four-wheelers and side-by-sides, cruise carts, and Yamaha golf carts. Bartram's has the full line of Kymco scooters. Don't forget, Bartram Power Sports offers a complete service department for all your service and repair needs. Stop by today and check out Bartram Power Sports, Highway 301 South in Jessup and their new location on Highway 341 next to I-95 in Brunswick.
Your Big Dog Country birthday cake winner on this Thursday morning. Happy 10th birthday to Aiden Boatwright. Aiden Boatwright picks up the cake from the Jessup Walmart Bakery. That certificate's here at the station. You'll come by, you'll pick that up, head to Walmart, claim your prize. Bartram Power Sports, Brunswick, Jessup online, bartrampowersports.com brings you birthdays and anniversaries. Wishing Aiden Boatwright happy 10th birthday, Big Dog Country birthday cake winner. Happy, happy birthday to Lee Sapp. Lee Sapp, we love and miss you and hope you have a fantastic day. Lee Sapp from Lucy, Bobby, Sandra, Michael, Blake, Levi, and Faith Olivia this morning for Lee Sapp. 7:37, Bob will check local sports, state news from GNN, look at your weather forecast, and a whole lot more on a Thursday morning here at the Big Dog.
Happy birthday.
Aiden Boatwright is 10, winner from the Jessup Walmart Bakery and WIFO.
Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020 at Wayne County High School. The following businesses, individuals, and organizations wish you good luck and good fortune in the years to come. Unity Church of God salutes Kaylee Alyssa Appler, Noah Lee Brandhurst, Kristen Lee Campbell, Brooklyn Cheyenne Manning,